Hello everyone, welcome to YellowGreys. In this video, we are going to learn how to filter data table using filter data table activity. Before we get into practice, look at our data which is available in the project folder. I have a sales report here which I designed for this demo purpose. You can see various columns names here like order ID, product, category and so on. Now we are going to read this entire data, then filtering country names based on our input country name. For example, I want to generate sales report of United States only in the next sheet. For that, what you will do manually, you have to go country column and filter the country name United States, then copy the whole data and create a new tab, then paste it over there, right? Then change tab name as country name. Remember the same scenario, we are going to try it in UiPath using filter data table activities. Let's get started. First, what we have to do? We have to read the complete sales report, right? For that, what we have to do? We have to use read range activity. Am I right? Okay. Let's drag and drop read range workbook activity. Click on the browse for file icon and select your input file. Add the sheet name and range. I want to read the entire sheet, so I will give double quotes to read the entire data. Let's create a data table variable to store our data. I will create the data table name as TT underscore sales report. Now we are done with the data storage part. Okay. Now add an assign activity or input dialog box to supply the country name, which we are going to filter from the stored data table. Let me use assign activity and create a variable name as str underscore country name. And in the value field, within double quotes, provide your country name. I will give the United States as the country name to filter, because I want to get only that particular country sales report. Now drag and drop filter data table activity from data table collection. Look at here, there are two input and one output parameter. In the data table field, call your data table variable, then click on configure filter wizard. Look at here, we have already called the input data table name and we have other option as well, that is an output data table. Let me create a new data table variable to store our filtered data. I will name it as DT underscore country table. Okay. Now you can see two tabs here, which is filter row and output columns. Here in the filter rows, you can filter data rows based on your input. We have three options here: column, operations and value. So in the column, we have to provide our data table column name which we are going to filter. I will supply my column name as country within double quotes. Then in the operation field, click on drop down button. You can see various conditions here. Choose appropriate one, which one you are exactly looking for. I will choose my country name equal to, because my country name should exactly match with given input parameter. Now in the value field, call your country input variable name, which we already declared. It means we are going to filter only United States from the data table. And we have other options as well, that is keep and remove. If you select the keep option here, whatever the conditions you are given the below, it will filter and keep your data in the output data table. If you select the remove option, it will remove the data based on the below given conditions, and it will store the remaining data into the data table. Let me choose the keep option since we are going to extract country-wise sales report. We have another tab which is output columns. This tab will help us to keep or remove our output data table. Let's say from this data table, I filter the country. If I need only product category and country columns, you have to mention the column name here and have to select the keep option. In the same case, if you select the remove option, as you mentioned, the column will be removed from your output data table. Let's remove this. As of now, we are not going to remove any columns. I hope you are clear as of now. Click on OK. We are almost done. Now we are in the place to see the output. Drag and drop right range workbook activity. Provide your output workbook file name path. I will choose the same input workbook path. In the sheet name field, call the country variable name, because I want to add the sheet with the country names. In starting cell, leave it as it is. In the data table field, call our output data table name, which is DT underscore country table. Now we are done. Let's go and run the process. The process execution is started. Now the execution is over. Let's go and check the output. Look at here, there is a new tab added with the country name, and we can see only we mentioned country sales details. Okay, let me close this and we'll execute with one more country. Go to assign activity, change the country name. I will change the country name to Canada. Let's execute the process. Now the execution is done. Go and check the workbook. Look at here, again one new tab added with the country name, and you can see the sales details for we mentioned country. I hope you are clear with filter data table activity. Thank you for watching. Please do subscribe and support. Connect with us for more tutorials.